What did I ever do for you that you should die for me?
Jesus left that place and went off to a territory near the cities of Tyre and Sidon. A Canaanite woman who lived in that region came to him. "Son of David," she cried out, "have mercy on me, sir. My daughter has a demon and is in a terrible condition." But Jesus did not say a word to her. His disciples came to him and begged him, "Send her away. She's following us and making all this noise." Then Jesus replied, "I have been sent only to the lost sheep of the people of Israel." At this, the woman came and fell at his feet. "Help me, sir," she said. Jesus answered, "It isn't right to take the children's food and throw it to the dogs." "That's true, sir," she answered. "But even the dogs eat the leftovers that fall from their master's table." So Jesus answered her, "You are a woman of great faith. What you want will be done for you." And at that very moment, her daughter was healed. I don't often share things that come up on my Facebook timeline, but this recently did, and I thought it was so good I would share it with you. It was entitled, "Don't Just Count Your Years, Make Your Years Count." What matters most in life is often viewed as peripheral to the things that we usually focus on. Passion takes a backseat to production, wellness to working, and balance to busyness. That old adage that life is not a dress rehearsal is so true, and yet we act to the contrary by putting off what is truly important or indulging things that are not. On your next birthday, stop focusing on your age and start meditating on your life at this exact moment. How can you make it better? During the next year, reshuffle your priorities. Spend more time with your family and friends. Take care of your body and health by eating well and exercising regularly. And offer to help others in need. Discover what matters most to you and make your daily life into your true reflection of those ideas, beliefs, and attitudes. Do you know what? I think that the Canaanite woman had those words sellotaped to her fridge. Yeah, I think she read them each and every day. Because what was her priority? Her family. She put them first and she wouldn't take no for an answer. It was her family's well-being. It was helping those in need. She had a greater understanding and a grasp of God, a greater trust and confidence than the disciples certainly did. She deserved everything she got, and that was the commendation of God and the healing of Jesus. How can we become more like the Canaanite woman? Well, for a start, we should live the gospel and let the gospel live in us. By thinking of the needs of others, by caring for those around you, and by being generous and wholehearted. Let us pray. Let peace return. O Lord, please bless our hearts with love, our minds with rest, our lives with harmony and trust. Help us to kneel now at your cross. Let peace return. O Lord, refill our hearts with gentle words, so this place becomes a sanctuary, a harbour safe, a hope retreat. Let peace return. O Lord, we need your words of life, to sow new seed, to grow new hope, to rise anew and find the light of forgiveness in you. Let peace return. O Lord, blow through our lives with grace and truth. Blow through the storms of life we sing, for our faith is in the peace you bring. Amen. I love this hymn, and in many ways it embodies that life of faith that the Canaanite woman was called to live out before Jesus, before her family. Will you come and follow me if I but call your name? Will you go where you don't know and never be the same? Will you let my love be shown? Will you let my name be known? Will you let my life be grown in you and you in me? Will you leave yourself behind if I could call your name? Be careful, cruel and kind and never be the same. Will you risk the hostile stare? Should your life attract to scare? Will you let me answer prayer in you and you in me? Will you let the blinded see if I could call your name? You set the prisoners free and never be the same. Will you kiss the leper clean and do such as this unseen? And admit to what I mean in you and you in me. Will you love the who you hide if I but call your name? Will you quit the fear inside and never be the same? Will you use the faith you found to reshape the world around through my sight and sound and touch in you and you in me? But your hands echoes true when